Hi, it's Giffin LeBates here, and today I had a question in my inbox from someone, and the question was, how can I trust a remote blockchain developer that I hire? Now, I think there's a number of different angles you can take when looking at that question. One is, how can you trust any person that you employ to do any job for you, whether remote or locally? I've had plumbers who've done bad jobs, I've had builders who've done bad jobs, I've had car mechanics who've done bad jobs, and they've all been local. Now, of course, the advantage with a local employee is that you can actually go and talk to them face to face and work out what is going on and size up the person so you can get an impression as to what they're like. So in the virtual world of remote working and computing, there is a similar thing, which is the reputation of the person. You can go and check out their social media profile, see if they have the kind of character and the kind of experience that you think is relevant. And that gives you insurance, because if somebody has a long work history with lots of good references, you've firstly got a good judge on whether they're going to do a good job or not. If they've got what I mentioned just before, then the answer is probably yes. And secondly, they've spent time building up a reputation, so it's not in their interest to try and run off with the money and give you a bad job. So that's the first thing, is if you're hiring a remote developer, get one who has a history of doing good work and has built up a reputation. Of course, those kind of developers are going to be more expensive, and you do kind of get what you pay for as long as you're careful in the remote working world. Blockchain, of course, has a different problem to most software projects, which is that you may well end up with the developer handling large sums of money or producing code that will move around large sums of money in the form of crypto assets. So when you've hired a blockchain developer to write a Solidity smart contract for you, you need to be careful that they haven't put a backdoor in that means at some point in the future they can run off with funds that have been deposited. Again, this is where reputation helps. If you have a clear profile of the person and they have a good reputation, then it is less likely that something like this will happen. If it's just some pseudo-anonymous or semi-anonymous person on the web that you found through some work site, then of course all bets will be off. So really, I think that kind of sums it up. It's just the same as the real world, except that maybe you don't know the person as well, or you can't get a handle on what they're like, and therefore it's up to you to A, do your background research, and B, pay for a good reputation rather than a non-existent one. And then, of course, the final thing is, if you're doing a blockchain project and you've hired a developer to write you some code, what you should also do is have that code audited by a second independent party, so that they can actually assess whether the job was done well or whether there are security vulnerabilities. And actually, this goes not just for blockchain development projects, it goes for ordinary software development as well, because you may get a developer to produce you a website with a database. If they don't do it properly, then you may fall foul of, for example, the GDPR laws. So there are financial risks associated with ordinary development projects as well, not just blockchain ones. Anyway, hope you found that useful or interesting. And if you have any questions, please feel free to message or email me with them, because they make interesting topics to produce videos for. I'll see you all in the next video soon. Bye for now.